Divine preservation. Key scripture text to consider. Deuteronomy chapter 6, verses 20 through 25. I'm rendering it from English Standard Version. When your son asks you in time to come, what is the meaning of the testimonies and the statutes and the rules that the Lord our God has commanded you? Then you shall say to your son, we were Pharaoh's slaves in Egypt, and the Lord brought us out of Egypt with a mighty hand. And the Lord showed signs and wonders, great and grievous, against Egypt and against Pharaoh and all his household, before our eyes. And he brought us out from there, that he might bring us in and give us the land that he swore to give to our fathers. And the Lord commanded us to do all these statutes, to fear the Lord our God for our good always, that he might preserve us alive as we are this day. And it will be righteousness for us if we are careful to do all these commandments before the Lord our God as he has commanded us. From my perspective, there are 5 points to consider from the above key scripture text. The first is the background of the people as captured in the verse 21. The background of Israel according to the scripture text is that of slavery or bondage. Here Israel became slaves to Pharaoh and his people. As such, they lived under the sole control and oppression of Pharaoh and the Egyptians. This background probably hindered their rights and freedoms as human beings and made it very challenging for them to pursue life pleasantly. That is when you consider Deuteronomy chapter 29, verse 16. The second point is God's act of deliverance, as emphasized in verses 21b and 23. It can be noticed that the activity of God was evident in securing deliverance for Israel, which he did by stretching out his mighty hand, that is power, to perform amazing events. The mighty hand of God, that is the mighty power of God, in effect, broke the power of Pharaoh, which in essence also broke the captivity of the Israelites. God's rationale for offering the Israelites deliverance was to disconnect them from the place of bondage, as captured in Exodus chapter 20 verse 2, in order to connect them to the land that he swore to give to their fathers, as captured in Deuteronomy chapter 6 verse 23, which was their place of freedom and prosperity. The third point is the experience of divine signs and wonders as revealed in verse 22. According to the text, God did not perform signs and wonders only in the sight of Egypt, Pharaoh and his household. It can be deduced that the people of Israel also witnessed those signs and wonders. The same text establishes that God performed those signs and wonders before the eyes of Israel. The nature of those signs and wonders, according to the record, was great and grievous, which suggested how awesome and awful those instances or events were. You can consider Psalm 135, verses 4 through 12, but you put emphasis on the verses 8 and 9. Those signs and wonders were experienced tangibly. To a greater extent, they depicted the sovereignty of God, thereby presenting God as one with sole might. The fourth point is the promise of God. God needed to perform those signs and wonders in the eyes of Egypt, Pharaoh, and his household in order to preserve Israel towards his promise. This was ultimate. The promise in this context is Canaan, a land that God promised and swore to give to their fathers. The land was meant to sustain them as well as ensure their welfare. God's promise to the Israelites was subsequently sealed by a covenant. This is captured in Deuteronomy chapter 29, verses 12-13. His promise to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob became the basis for establishing the covenant with Israel with a solitary purpose to give them the land. Nevertheless, in Deuteronomy chapter 29, verses 13-15, it was not with Israel alone that God established the covenant. The covenant was made between whosoever was present on the day, that is, whosoever was present in the presence of God, as well as extended to those who were absent. The fifth point is what I describe as terms and conditions. Moses in the verses 24 and 25 of Deuteronomy chapter 6 points out the terms and conditions to the Israelites. The terms and conditions as outlined were intended to alert Israel to maintain a good standing with God. Inferring from the two verses, the terms and conditions that accompanied the promise of God entailed doing or observing all the statutes of God as well as fearing God. That is, Israel was commanded by the Lord to do all his statutes, and they were to fear God for their own good so that he will preserve them alive. This is captured in Deuteronomy chapter 6, verses 24 through 25. It serves right to state that Israel's welfare and continuity in life was subject to their compliance or obedience, reverence, and faithfulness to God. I have sought to draw out some points to justify the scripture text, that is Deuteronomy chapter 6, verses 20 through 25. It must be understood that a life that is not preserved will lose its full sense of existence. The Word Web Dictionary defines preservation as the activity of protecting something from loss or danger. It further explains it as a process that saves organic substance from decay. To preserve in this sense is to simply keep or maintain something in an altered condition, to cause that thing to remain or last, to keep in safety and protect something from harm, decay, loss, or destruction. The term in other usage means keeping up and reserving something for personal or special use. There is again an idea which explains the term as to prevent something from getting rotten, example food, to maintain something in safety from injury, harm, or danger in order to keep it undisturbed for personal or private use. The concept of preservation in this setting has a similar bearing on the biblical form of preservation. For instance, human life cannot hold if the key components of the human being, that is the soul, the spirit, body, are not preserved. This accords well with what Paul asserts in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 23. The various meanings that accompany the term preserved, as discussed above, are borrowed from the Word Web Dictionary. It presents the concept considering varieties of contexts. In the light of the Bible, the term is applied as giving of life, sustaining of life, restoring of life, quickening or reviving of life, and repairing of life. The next session explores some meanings of the term from the biblical perspectives, considering the Hebrew and Greek etymologies, and also considers the idea they hold to aid the reader understand in context. The Old Testament and the New Testament both place the term preservation in unique settings. That is, both the Hebrew and Greek terms will be displayed in their transliterated form, and facts will be drawn from the New Strong Expanded Dictionary of Bible Words, as written by James Strong. This will be treated also from the perspective of the theological word book of the New and Old Testament. I will dwell on the Hebrew and Greek meanings to connect the reader to the very ideas that accompany the term preservation. Just as I said, the Old Testament and the New Testament both place the term preservation in unique settings, yet it can be identified that in all placements, the basic concept relating to preservation, as in keeping something from decay, rottenness, or destruction, is not lost. And now let's consider some biblical perspectives on preservation by first considering the Old Testament etymologies. First term is shayah. Shayah is a Hebrew term for preserve, as captured in Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 24. Shayah is a Hebrew term which, when expanded, means to live, to have life, to remain alive, to sustain life, to live prosperously, to live forever, to be quickened, to be alive, to be restored to life or health, to continue in life, to revive, as in from sickness, discouragement, faintness, death, etc., to cause, to grow, to nourish, and to save. This term is tapped in its original form from James Strong, as contained in the new Strong's Expanded Dictionary of the Bible. The following scripture quotations can be considered in terms of portrayed concept, that is Genesis chapter 5 verse 3, Numbers chapter 14 verse 38, Joshua chapter 9 verse 21, Genesis chapter 6 verse 19, Isaiah chapter 57 verse 15. The second term, Mitshah is a Hebrew term for preserve, as generated from Genesis chapter 45 verse 5. In certain instances, it means to recover. Mitshah holds the meaning preservation of life, which brings about sustenance. This form is likened to victuals. What are victuals? Victuals have to do with what needs to be eaten to sustain a person's body. It is usually connected to food, especially food containing the required vitamins and energy. It can be talked about as that which brings nourishment or sustenance. So preservation in this case may be applied as a point where God keeps us from things that hinder our growth and hence endows us with power to stay active in order to thrive in life. The third term, Sumsim is a Hebrew term for preserve, as tapped from Genesis chapter 45 verse 7. You can also consider Genesis chapter 2 verse 8, Exodus chapter 40 verse 8, Exodus chapter 8 verse 12, Micah chapter 5 verse 1, 1 Kings chapter 20 verse 12, 1 Samuel chapter 15 verse 2, Psalm 54 verse 3, Ezekiel 14 verse 4, Exodus chapter 1 verse 11, 1 Samuel chapter 8 verse 5, Genesis chapter 22 verse 9, Genesis chapter 30 verse 36. Sumsim is primarily defined as to put, to place, to set, to appoint, to assign, to continue, to ordain, to establish, to fix, to transform into, to bring to pass, to make for a sign, to care, to consider, to regard. The fourth point, Natsa is a Hebrew term for preserve, as used in Psalm 12 verse 7. Natsa conveys the meaning to guard, to watch, to guard from dangers, to watch over, to keep secret, to guard with fidelity, be blockaded, to protect, to maintain, to observe. This form is likened to a watcher or watchman. The fifth term, Shama is a Hebrew term for preserve, as captured in Psalm 16 verse 1. Shama is presented as to save life, to have charge of, to give heed, to retain, to treasure as in memory, to keep, that is within bounds, to restrain, to celebrate, to reserve, to take care. The primitive root of this Hebrew term means to properly hedge about, as with tongues, that is guard. Generally, it means to protect or attend to and be circumspect. The sixth point, Yata is a Hebrew term for preserved, as used in Psalm 79 verse 11. We can also consider Genesis chapter 30 verse 36, 2 Samuel chapter 9 verse 1, Ezekiel chapter 6 verse 8. Yata means to be left over, to remain over, and to be left behind. Here the picture painted seems odd or negative. The term stands out to be such, but there is another side of it with the following application: to save over, preserve alive, to excel, to show preeminence, and to have more than enough. Intransitively, it is to remain or be left. Causatively, it is to cause to abound, that is, make plenty and reserve. The seventh point is malat. Malat is a Hebrew term for preserved. Malat is a Hebrew term for preserve, as used in Isaiah chapter 31 verse 5. Also, Genesis chapter 19 verse 17. 1 Samuel chapter 19 verse 10 and 12. Isaiah chapter 20 verse 6. Isaiah chapter 66 verse 7. 2 Kings chapter 10 verse 24. Malat, in its original usage, means to let slip away, to let escape, to deliver, to save, and to be delivered. Considering the primitive root, properly it is to be smooth. By implication, it is to escape, as if by slipperiness. Causatively, it is to release or rescue. Specifically, it is to bring forth. So you realize that I've dealt with Hebrew terminologies as far as the term preserve is concerned, and I've connected you to the very etymologies that these terms hold. Now let me connect you to the New Testament perspective or concept of preservation by dwelling on Greek etymologies. The first term, zugoneo, is a Greek term for preserve, as captured in Luke chapter 17 verse 33 and also Acts chapter 7 verse 19. Zugoneo is defined as to bring forth alive, to give life, to preserve life, to live, to engender alive, that is by analogy, and to rescue passively, to be saved from death. The second term is zozo is a Greek term for preserve, as used in 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 18. We can also consider Matthew chapter 8 verse 25, Mark chapter 13 verse 20, Luke chapter 23 verse 35, John chapter 12 verse 27, 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 15, 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 18. Zozo by implication means to save, to rescue from danger or destruction, that is, as in injury or peril, to save a suffering one from perishing, to make well or restore to health one suffering from disease, to keep safe and sound. This is when the term is applied in the technical sense. The modified version of this Greek term is to deliver one from the penalties of the messianic judgment, and also to save one from evils which obstruct the reception of the messianic deliverance. There are traditional and scientific methods of preservation where various elements and approaches are applied to keep things from destruction. For us Christians, our preservation is spiritual, as it is perfectly secured through a highly spiritual means by a great God in Christ Jesus. That is when we consider Jude 1:1. It must be understood that although the mode of God's preservation in the Christian setting takes a spiritual form, It has a tangible effect on our physical life, thereby sustaining us in all that we do. From typical traditional and scientific perspectives or standards, people use elements such as salt, fire, light, water, oil, sand, chemicals, or some scientific systems or technology, among other things, to sustain life and things. In a Christian setting, the standard is Christ Jesus. We are perfectly preserved in Christ Jesus. Not only does God preserve us, He also helps us and exalts us. That is Psalm 116 verse 6. In preserving us, God in Christ preserves us unto that which is glorious and blessed. May God preserve you now and forever. Before I move on for us to pray, I want us to briefly consider some facts about divine preservation. God preserves our spirits, souls, and bodies. That is 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 23. We can also consider Job chapter 10 verse 12, Psalm 86 verse 2. There is a divine power released to safely preserve our environment and everything therein. This is captured in Nehemiah chapter 6 verse 9. We can also consider Psalm 36 verse 6. I'm still talking about facts about divine preservation. When it comes to divine preservation, experiencing God preserves our lives. This is captured in Genesis chapter 32, verse 30. We can say that every Christian is mandated to preserve lives. That is when we consider Genesis chapter 45, verses 5 through 7. It is God's will to preserve us alive. This is when we consider Deuteronomy chapter 6 verse 24. Related scripture passages can be found also in Joshua chapter 24 verse 17, Psalm 12 verse 7, Psalm 41 verse 2, Jeremiah chapter 49 verse 11. God preserved the godly everywhere they go. We can dwell on 2 Samuel chapter 8 verse 6 and 14 as far as this claim is concerned. We can also consider 1 Chronicles chapter 18 verse 6 and 13, and then Psalm 121 verse 8. The wicked or the ungodly will not be preserved. This is when we consider Job chapter 36 verse 6. Related scripture text can be found also in Psalm 145 verse 20, Psalm 146 verse 9. The faithful shall surely be preserved. That is when we consider Psalm 31 verse 23. We can also consider Psalm 37 verse 28, Psalm 145 verse 20, and then Proverbs chapter 2 verse 8. Those who put their trust in God will be preserved. That is when we consider Psalm 16 verse 1. God preserves even animals within our home. This is when we consider carefully Psalm 36 verse 6. Integrity and uprightness preserves. This is when we consider Psalm 25 verse 21. We can also consider Proverbs chapter 2 verse 11. And then Proverbs chapter 20 verse 28. God preserves us from trouble, all evil, and the evil one. Consider Psalm 32 verse 7. Related scripture passages can be found also in Psalm 41 verse 2, Psalm 121 verse 7, Psalm 140 verse 1. We are preserved by the mercies, love, and truth of God. That is when we consider Psalm 40 verse 11. And also Psalm 61 verse 7. The preservation of God comes along with blessings and establishment. Consider Psalm 41 verse 2. And also Isaiah chapter 49 verses 6 through 8. The Lord preserves us from any evil directed against us. Consider Psalm 79 verse 11. And also Psalm 140 verse 4. Your utterance has the power to preserve you or put you into trouble. Consider Proverbs chapter 14 verse 3 and Proverbs chapter 16 verse 17. The preservation of God is governed by divine defense and deliverance. That is when we consider Isaiah chapter 31 verse 6. Godly leaders are agents of preservation. This is when we carefully consider Hosea chapter 12 verse 13. Preservation without wisdom is worthless. That is when we consider Matthew chapter 9 verse 17 and also Luke chapter 5 verse 38. As Christians, our ultimate preservation is rooted in Christ Jesus. This is when we consider Luke chapter 17 verse 33. Our ultimate preservation is unto purity and towards the second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. That is when we carefully consider or examine 1 Thessalonians 5 verse 20. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 23. Christians are preserved unto the Lord's heavenly kingdom. This is when we consider 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 18. Finally, we are called, sanctified and perfectly preserved only in Christ Jesus. This is when we consider Jude 1:1. I pray the best for you as you pray through the prayers. May God preserve you and set you up for that which is glorious. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, God. I thank you, God, in the name of Jesus, that you are the preserver of my life. You are the preserver of my life. In the name of Jesus, I have no one that can preserve me. No one that can sustain my life. No one that can uphold my life. You are the preserver. You are the chief preserver. You are the sole preserver of my life. You are the preserver of my life. I thank you, God. I thank you, God, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. I thank you, God. I thank you, God. I thank you this day that you are the preserver of my life. The preserver of my life. The sustainer of my life. The protector of my life. The keeper of my life. I thank you. I thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I thank you in the name of Jesus Christ. I thank you, God, that you offer absolute preservation to those who trust in you. In the name of Jesus, to those who trust in you, you offer absolute protection, absolute preservation. And so the psalmist said, the Lord is a shield. You are a shield unto those who put their trust in you. Those who put their trust in you, you are their shield. You are their preserver. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you that you offer total preservation to those who trust in you. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. As my preserver, I plead with you to forgive all my sins. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, forgive my sins. Forgive my sins. There are times that I have gone, oh God, against your word. I've gone contrary to your statutes. I've gone contrary to your commandments. I've gone contrary to your decrees. I've gone contrary, oh God, to your word. I admit that I've gone contrary to your word. I admit that I've gone contrary to your word. And so I present myself as a sinner. That forgive me of my sins. Forgive me of my sins and preserve my soul. Forgive me of my sins and preserve my soul. Forgive me of my sins and preserve my soul. Forgive me of my sins and preserve my spirit. Forgive me of my sins, O God, and preserve my spirit. Forgive me of my sins, O Lord, and preserve my body.
preserve my body, that there wouldn't be any decay, that there wouldn't be any destruction, that there wouldn't be any, oh God, decay, any destruction. Forgive me, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I plead with you. Let the blood of Jesus Christ cleanse my sins, wash off my sins. Wash off my sins. Wash off my sins. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, extend your mercies. Extend your mercies to me and save me from the consequences of my iniquities. In the name of Jesus. For the wages of sin, oh God, is death. The wages of sin is death. I pray in the name of Jesus that as you forgive my sins, oh God, extend your mercies. Extend your mercies and save me from the consequences of my iniquities. Save me from the consequences of my iniquities. Whatever will bring death upon my spirit, whatever will bring death upon my soul, whatever will bring death upon my body because I have sinned, I pray in the name of Jesus that God forgive me. Forgive me, and let your mercies, oh God, prevail. Let your mercies, oh God, prevail. Save me from the consequences of my iniquities. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. For Jacob said, I have seen God face to face, and my life is preserved. I have seen God face to face, and my life is preserved. Anytime we encounter you, you preserve us. You preserve us. I have encountered your spirit, your presence. Your presence is here. Your presence is here. By your presence, preserve my life. By your presence, preserve my life. I have seen you this day face to face. Oh God, preserve me. Oh God, preserve my life. Preserve my life. Preserve my life from perishing. Preserve my life from perishing. In the name of Jesus Christ, preserve me for a special use and set me up as a blessing unto many. Preserve me for a special use and set me up as a blessing. In the name of Jesus, I agree with, oh God, Moses, when he said, the Lord will preserve us alive as we are today. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that preserve me alive as I am today. Preserve my soul alive as I am today. Preserve my spirit alive as I am today. Preserve my body alive as I am today. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Preserve me alive. Preserve me alive. Keep my household alive and let us live a safe and sound life. In the name of Jesus Christ, keep me alive and let me live a sound life. In the name of Jesus, I agree with your son Joshua when he said, it is God who took us from the house of bondage, the place of bondage, Egypt. It is God who led us, oh, from the place of bondage, who brought us out from there, who brought us in to give us the land. And it is the Lord who preserved us in all our ways. I pray this day in the name of Jesus, that as you preserve me alive, preserve me in all my ways, in all my dealings, in all my pursuits, in all my endeavors. Preserve me, oh God. Preserve me to preserve me. Assign your angels to guard and preserve me from the dangers of this life. As I go through life, preserve me. Let your angels, oh God, go before me. And by the presence of your angels, let my ways be preserved. Let my steps be preserved. Let my moves be preserved. In the name of Jesus, let my moves, oh God, be preserved. Let my ways, oh God, be preserved. Let my ways, oh God, be preserved. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. I plead you to preserve me from any death. Any death that is appointed for me this year. Any death that is appointed for me this month. Any death that is appointed for me this week. Any death that is appointed for me this day. Any death that is appointed for me this moment. Preserve me from that death. Preserve me from that death. I agree with your word that says, according to the greatness of your power, preserve those that are appointed to die. Any appointment of death, I pray in the name of Jesus that God preserve me from such. Preserve me from such. And on this note, I declare that I am preserved. I am preserved from every appointment of death. In the name of Jesus Christ, I am preserved. I am preserved. My life is preserved. My body is preserved. My spirit is preserved. My soul is preserved. No death can come upon me. No death can take over my future. No death can crush my future. No death can terminate my destiny. I will not die prematurely. I will not die prematurely. I will not die prematurely. For I am preserved. For I am preserved. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let my seed, O God, be preserved. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, cause me, O God, to bring forth that which is positive and glorious as you preserve me. Let my life produce. Let my life produce or bring forth that which is positive and glorious. In the name of Jesus Christ, I agree with your word that says, for you shall preserve my going out and my coming in. O God, I pray, preserve my going out and my coming in the name of Jesus Christ. Preserve the going out of my children. Preserve the going out of my husband. Preserve the going out of my wife. Every member of my household, preserve us, preserve us, preserve our going out, preserve our coming in the name of Jesus Christ. Wherever you are, I declare that you are preserved. You are preserved. The Lord will preserve your going out. The Lord will preserve your coming in the name of Jesus Christ. Nothing can crush your way. Nothing can stop your steps. Nothing can stop you as you pursue life. Nothing can stop you. You go out there and be successful. Your going out will be successful. Your coming in will be successful. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, you said you preserve our going out and our coming in. And you shall preserve us from all evil. All evil. I pray in the name of Jesus that God preserve me from all evil. Preserve me from all evil. Preserve my life from all evil. Every evil that has been programmed against me, every evil that is coded against me, preserve me from such. Preserve me from such. Every evil that is coded, that is awaiting manifestation, oh God, preserve me from that evil. Every evil that is put, that as I go through life, I will be trapped. I will be trapped. I'll be trapped. Preserve me. Preserve me. Preserve me from the traps of the enemy. Preserve me from any satanic snare, any satanic plots, any satanic, oh God, traps. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. Let every single thing within my entire household be preserved. In the name of Jesus. I agree with your word, oh God, as captured in Nehemiah. For you created the heavens and everything therein. You created the sea and everything therein. You created the earth and everything therein. And the host of heaven worship you. I pray if the earth, the sea, the heavens are preserved by you, O God. Oh, preserve me. Preserve my household. Let every single thing within my household, O God, be preserved. As long as you preserve the heavens, as long as you preserve the sun, as long as you preserve the moon, as long as, O God, the stars are preserved, as long as the sea, you preserve it. You preserve the sea. As long as you preserve this earth, I pray in the name of Jesus. Oh, let everything within my household also be preserved. Father, the things in heaven, the things within the heavens are preserved. The things within the sea, oh, they are preserved. The things on this earth are preserved. I therefore pray in the name of Jesus. Let my domain preserve everything within my domain.
preserve everything within my terrain. Preserve everything within, oh God, my environment. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. Keep every single thing within my household. Living things, non-living things. I beseech you to preserve. I agree with your word that says you preserve man and even the beast. If domestic animals are preserved, I pray in the name of Jesus, let my life be preserved. Every single thing within my household be preserved. Preserve my cars. Preserve my cars. Preserve my properties. Preserve my children. Preserve every member of my household. Preserve our nation. Preserve this world. In the name of Jesus Christ. Every single thing within. Every single thing within. I agree with your word. As the apostle Paul said, I pray that the Lord will preserve your body. I pray that the Lord will preserve your soul. I pray that the Lord will preserve your spirit holy unto the coming of the Lord Jesus. Father, if, oh, according to the apostle, you preserve the soul, the spirit, the body of man, I pray in the name of Jesus, if the bodies, the souls, the spirits of humankind, oh God, are preserved, I pray in the name of Jesus, preserve my soul this day. Preserve my spirit this day. Preserve my body this day. Preserve my spirit from any satanic projections, any satanic manipulations, any satanic, oh God, projections. In the name of Jesus, whatever is directed against my spirit, oh, preserve me against that. Whatever is directed against my spirit, any enchantments, any projections, any manipulations, in the name of Jesus Christ, preserve my spirit. And as you preserve my spirit, fortify my spirit against every evil. Fortify my spirit against every trouble. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh God, preserve my soul. Preserve my soul. And as you preserve my soul, let me live at peace. Let me live at peace. Let my soul be so sound. In the name of Jesus. The soul which is the seat of my appetite. The soul which is the seat of my passion. The soul which is the seat of my will. The soul which is the seat of my emotion. Let my soul be preserved that I will not live a sorrowful life. Let my soul be preserved so that I will stay cheerful in the name of Jesus, that I will stay joyful in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, that life will not be unbearable. Let my soul register that which is good because it is preserved. Any bitterness that will come upon my soul, any hurts, any pains, in the name of Jesus, preserve my soul against such. Preserve my soul against such. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, preserve my soul against such. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. Oh God, preserve my body. Preserve my body this day. And as you preserve my body from any physical accident, any incident, any accident, any calamity, any trouble, any attack, any robbery that will come upon me to affect my body. Preserve, 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 preserve my body, oh God, from diseases, any sicknesses that will come upon my body, oh, to eat my body up, to cause my body to deteriorate. I pray in the name of Jesus, let my body be preserved. And as you preserve my body, grant me good health. Let me live a sound health life for a sound life. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I agree with your word when the psalmist said, oh, you are my hiding place. Thou shalt preserve me from trouble and encompass me with songs of deliverance. I this day pray, oh God, preserve me from trouble. Preserve me from trouble. Every existing trouble, every impending trouble, preserve me this day from such. In the name of Jesus Christ, every trouble that is appointed for me this day, every impending trouble appointed for me this year, this month, this week, this day, this very hour, I pray in the name of Jesus, preserve me from such. Preserve me from such. And may you encompass me with songs of deliverance. Be my refuge. Be my hiding place.
be my hiding place in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I agree with your word that says, as Job said, he said, you have granted me life. You have granted me life and favor. Your visitation has preserved my spirit. May this day be a day of visitation. As you visit to preserve my spirit, may this day be a day of visitation. As you visit, oh God, to preserve my soul, may it be a day of visitation. As you visit to preserve my body, and as you preserve, grant me life and favor. Grant me life and favor. Grant me life and favor. And may I live the fullness of my life on this earth. In the name of Jesus Christ, according to your will, according to your plans, in the name of Jesus Christ, I agree with your word that says, let your loving kindness and your mercy, your truth, preserve me, for I count on you. Oh God, this day, let your loving kindness and truth continually preserve me in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your loving kindness, oh God, and truth preserve me, preserve me, preserve my household in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, preserve me in all my ways, 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 all that I do, all that I do, preserve me. Preserve me, preserve me, preserve me, preserve me. I agree with your word that says, for you keep me alive. You preserve me and keep me alive. I shall be blessed upon the earth, and you not hand me over unto the will of my enemies. Father, I pray, keep me, preserve me, bless me, and do not hand me over unto the will of my enemies. Do not hand me over unto the will of my enemies. In the name of Jesus Christ, preserve me from the fear and terror of the enemy. Of the enemy, of the enemy, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, preserve me from the hand of the wicked one. The wicked one. I agree with the psalmist. Oh, when he says, preserve me from the wicked one who has purposed to overthrow my goings. Whatever the wicked one has purposed for me, whatever the wicked one has assigned for me, whatever the wicked one has employed against me, preserve me from such, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, preserve my life and help me out of every challenging situation. In the name of Jesus Christ, preserve my life, oh God, from the violent person, from the violent one. In the name of Jesus, the violent one, and whatever he or she has purposed against me. In the name of Jesus, Father, as you preserve, let integrity and uprightness preserve me. I agree. I accept your word. Your word says, let integrity and uprightness preserve me. Your word says, integrity and uprightness shall preserve us. I therefore pray according to your word that God, let integrity and uprightness preserve me throughout life. In the name of Jesus Christ, 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 let my utterance possess life, that as I will declare, they will, oh God, go forth to preserve lives. May my utterance not bring evil. May my utterance not bring destruction. Preserve my speech, that my speech will give life. My speech will not destroy. In the name of Jesus Christ, preserve me and restore the fortunes of my tent. Preserve me, oh God, and restore me unto my original position. Preserve me, oh God, preserve me, oh God, and give me as a light and covenant unto those in darkness. In the name of Jesus Christ, in the name of Jesus Christ, Father, as you preserve, help me out of every hopeless and miserable situation. Every miserable situation, keep me from such. In the name of Jesus Christ, whatever situation I find myself in, that is so challenging, that is so difficult, I pray that as you preserve, preserve me unto that which is good. Preserve me unto that which is good. Preserve me unto that which is good. And here, may you deal with my hopelessness. May you deal with my hopelessness. May you deal with my hopelessness. Any miserable condition I find myself in, let there be, O God. Let there be, O God. Let there be, O God, preservation. Let there be, O God, preservation, that you preserve me. Preserve me and keep me from the destruction of the evil one. Every situation that is meant for my destruction, every situation that is meant for my destruction, every situation that is meant for my termination, every destruction that is meant for my obstruction, I pray in the name of Jesus, preserve me from that situation. Preserve me from that situation and set me up as a blessing. Render me, O God, as a blessing unto many, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, preserve me unto your heavenly kingdom. In the name of Jesus Christ, preserve me, preserve me, preserve me. I agree. Your word says, to them that are called, to them that are sanctified, to them that are preserved in Christ Jesus, in Christ Jesus, upon your word I pray. Let me be preserved in Christ Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let me be preserved in Christ Jesus, in Christ Jesus. Let me perfectly be preserved in Christ Jesus, in the name of Jesus. And as long as you preserve me in Christ, let me live my days in peace and joy. Let me live the rest of my days in peace and joy, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let me live to enjoy all the days that you have ordained for me, in the name of Jesus. Preserve my dreams. Preserve my vision, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let my dreams live. Let my vision live, in the name of Jesus. The dreams that I hold on to, the visions that I hold on to, Father, may they not die. May they not die. Preserve them. Preserve them and set them up as a blessing unto many, in the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I declare, my dreams shall live. My vision shall live. My dream will not die. My vision will not die. They will live. They will live. They will live. Because I am preserved. Because I am preserved. Because I am preserved. Father, as you preserve, preserve me unto that which is glorious. Preserve me unto glorious experiences. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I am thankful to you for keeping me safe. I am thankful to you for keeping my household safe. I praise you with all my heart, in the name of Jesus Christ. I thank you. I thank you for an answered prayer. I thank you, O God, for an answered prayer, in the name of Jesus Christ. I thank you that which the enemy programmed, you've preserved me from such, that their schemes, their imaginations, their plots did not prevail because of your preservation. Glory, honor be unto your name, now and forevermore. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, amen.